Hello guys, I'm sitting in the cockpit of this Curtiss Jenny Texas Star, brought to you by Ford Trey Motor Team. And this model is beautiful except for the bug that is common among this model and maybe some other like Globe Swift, but I managed to live with that bug and fly Globe Swift by, well, it's actually irrelevant who made Swift, but just for your information, the bug exists and it makes life even harder than it was in the time of those wooden aircrafts. So, the bug actually originates from this effect of pushing the aircraft forwards when you engage throttle. And as this one has no wheels, no wheel brakes, I will have to carefully adjust throttle to rotate. I'm braking with those elements of undercarriage on the, what could we say, a wingtip. There is no speed indicator. Fuel indicator is visible from the first seat, and from here we just could see if it's either full or empty, but nothing specific. Also, something strange about this aircraft. Maybe I should push this button finally. Let's start it. When I first launched this model, a cylinder heads were animated, but maybe if I hit pause, now, well, maybe that's another bug, specific just for that one model. I'm going to taxi her, at least try to taxi her to the runway. As I'm saying, there's no brakes, there's only whiskey compass, oil temperature indicator, some RPM indicator, she needs only short run to take off. And you could see your speed from the wind that's blowing. And on all those fabric and ropes. Well, this is actually a beautiful aircraft to fly. I'm going to try and land somewhere the aircraft of this class could land. Maybe right there. Thank you. No, not there. Not really. Would be too dangerous. Just imagine. A kind of this aircraft was once owned by Amelia Earhart. There is no brakes, no flaps. If you hear that silence, that means you are near the stall speed. You should increase a little when you can hear slight wind. I'm going not on the runway, but on the grass, on the right. That should be, well, on such ancient aircraft, the undercarriage, as I named this installation, and as Brits often name this thing, is very fragile. You see, on this one it's wooden, so collision with some hard surface is something that should be avoided. You should either land this on some grass strips or don't land there at all. This is even more fragile than Polycarpa Podva. So, oh, I almost forgot. No brakes. Definitely this is not the aircraft I would want to fit with a GPS, but I'll try to find the way to get her into FSX Command. There's a repaint kit available at Ford Trimotor Project, and well, this is as close to full stop as I actually can achieve. So, what do I switch this off with? Magneta or fuel valve? Let's stay with Magneta. I feel really tired. Well, it's my second video for this day. Oh, no, not the second, the third one. And it was rather unexpected. So, A Jenny is a Jenny. Till the next time, ride safe, fly safe, and stay tuned for more unique aircrafts. And maybe after I practice a bit, I'll show you a couple of tricks with those rare beauties.